Hello Baycroft, happy Friday and welcome to today's special VE Day episode of Baycroft YouTube. Well, firstly, what an amazing last couple of days we've had with our rainbow episodes. I've really enjoyed seeing all the work you've set in. We hope you've enjoyed seeing all the staff. Well, today's episode is going to be based on what happened 75 years ago today. Germany has surrendered in World War II, and the people of Great Britain finally had something to celebrate about. They had great big street parties. We'll be looking at more of that later on. And it was the first time in a long time, through many years of darkness, they could finally see the light at the end of the tunnel. And we're hoping today, in our current situation, that we'll have things to look forward to too. Anyway, I'm not going to talk for too much longer because we've got a really packed show and I really hope you enjoy what we're going to have today.
It'd be impossible on this commemorative day not to link VE Day and resilience to this inspirational man. Previously known as Captain Tom Moore, a 99-year-old Second World War veteran who raised nearly £33 million for the NHS by walking 100 laps of his garden using a Zimmer frame. What a demonstration of resilience. Captain Tom Moore, who turned 100 on Thursday, April the 30th, wanted to complete the challenge at his home in Bedfordshire before his birthday to support medics on the front line of the coronavirus crisis. He says these are national heroes. The former tank commander had set a target of £1,000, which he reached in just 24 hours, but went on to raise an astonishing figure for the NHS charities. He became Colonel Tom as the MOD announced an honorary promotion for his 100th birthday. This momentous day was also celebrated up and down the country with over 140,000 birthday cards being sent to the Colonel alongside thousands of presents and cakes. He has definitely done his bit to keep spirits high across the UK and has demonstrated through resilience we can achieve amazing things. Over to you, Colonel Tom.
Eventually we'll win. We always do win in this country. Sometimes it takes time, but this time we will certainly win.
What's happening here? Look carefully at the image on the slide. What historical information can you spot? What year or period do you think this is? It's 1945. What can you tell from what the people are wearing? Some are soldiers, some are citizens. These are everyday people. What can you tell from what the people are doing? They're celebrating some kind of event. The flags being waved indicate that the people are British. What event are they celebrating? Victory in Europe Day. VE Day. And when was VE Day? The 8th of May 1945. What was VE Day? Victory in Europe, 8th of May 1945. After 6 years of devastating war, Germany signed an unconditional surrender on the 7th of May 1945. Finally, the war in Europe was at an end. Interrupting its usual programming, the BBC broadcast to the nation that the war in Europe was over and that the next day, the 8th of May, would be a public holiday known as VE Day. Huge crowds gathered in public spaces. This is Trafalgar Square in London. There were more celebrations around the world, from the USA to Australia. So VE Day was a national holiday, declared the day after Germany's unconditional surrender to Allied forces. And it marked the end of hostilities in Europe. Why was VE Day an occasion for happiness then? Because it marked the end of the war in Europe, which had gone on for 6 long years. And this day marked the end of one of the darkest periods in modern history. Why was VE Day also a day for reflection or sadness? Well, because the war had not yet been won. Forces were still fighting in the Pacific, and many terrible battles would take place before the true end of the war. Secondly, people might reflect on and be sad about the number of people who'd died along the way to VE Day. The war ended in Europe, but not elsewhere. VE Day marked the end of conflict in Europe, but not the end of hardship. People still had family members who were serving abroad or confined in prisoner of war camps. Many servicemen were sent to the Pacific to continue to fight. The war in the Pacific would continue until August 1945. Rationing in Britain would continue until 1954. However, VE Day marked the point that people across Europe could begin to rebuild their lives. When the Prime Minister, Winston Churchill, gave his radio address, he included a note of caution that the war continued elsewhere in the world. Britain would continue to fight in the Pacific until August 1945, and many British and Commonwealth soldiers would not be demobilised or taken away from active war zones for months or even years afterwards, being sent instead to help with post-war occupation, liberation and repair. Churchill also knew it wouldn't be easy for Britain to recover from the war. For many, VE Day was a time of mourning. The financial and political effects of the war were significant. Britain was virtually bankrupt, and the post-war years were ones of hardship. The end of the war marked the beginning of the end of the British Empire and the start of the Cold War between the West and the Soviet Union. These children are celebrating on VE Day in the rubble of their bombed street. They've known nothing but conflict during their lives. What's important about May the 8th? This year, the May bank holiday is being moved to mark the 75th anniversary of VE Day. It's a day to remember the contribution of British, Commonwealth and Allied forces during World War II, including those on the home front. It's also an opportunity to pay tribute for those who have served and continue to serve in the UK Armed Forces. VE Day marked the end of years of fighting, destruction and death across Europe. Britain alone lost 384,000 military personnel, including Commonwealth personnel, and 67,000 civilians. People from every walk of life endured incredible hardships. Many soldiers gave their lives and never returned home. When we commemorate VE Day, we remember the sacrifices these people made to preserve their freedom. Without them, we could not enjoy the many freedoms we enjoy today.
Baycroft, welcome to the Baycroft Bake Off. So today I am going to be making cupcakes. In my opinion, and my husband's, the best cupcakes that there are. So what you will need to make your cupcakes is some good old self-raising flour. Please do not look at the brand, other brands are available. You will also need some caster sugar. Once again, other brands are available. You will need some butter, and you will need two eggs. You will also need some icing sugar if you're going to make buttercream. In your buttercream, you add a little bit of vanilla essence just for the taste. The equipment that you will need is obviously a baking tray, a mixing bowl, and a set of scales. In my opinion, scales should only be used for weighing ingredients, nothing else. And then when you've done that, sorry, I forgot to tell you how much you need to use. Duh. Silly Mrs. Horsley, as always. So, you will need 4 ounces or 110 grams of flour, caster sugar and butter. You mix your caster sugar and your butter together first. You slowly add your flour with an egg at a time. Whisk it all up. If you want to add some chocolate chips or you want to add some coconut like I've added to mine, you can. You put it all into the most important thing in the world, the oven. You bake them for about half an hour, and then once that timer goes, you will get.
Hi guys, Mrs. Burke here. I'm going to be making chocolate salted caramel brownies for the Baycroft Bake Off. Fingers crossed.
Hi Baycroft, Mrs. Dale here in my kitchen. Today I'm going to be baking you a cake for the great Baycroft Bake Off. I'm going to be making you a Victoria sandwich. It's a classic cake filled with jam and cream with sprinkles of caster sugar on the top. Hope you like it. Bye for now. Keep safe.
Hi, Mrs. Blackledge here. Today I'm going to be baking a cake. I'm baking the cake for the Great Baycroft Bake Off. Can't say that too fast. My cake is going to be a rainbow chip cake, just like this one. Shh, don't tell Mrs. Dale. And when I'm icing it, I'm going to be using some rainbow sprinkles.
Hi Baycroft, Mrs. Skinner here. So the cake I'm going to be making is just a Victoria sponge, basically, but I'm going to decorate it with a rainbow. Using these bad boys, if I can manage not to eat them first.
Hello, I'm Miss Whittle, and I'm going to make you my famous chocolate brownie for the bake-off.
Hello, I'm going to be making cheese scones with a twist.
Good morning Baycroft, Miss Miles here in the kitchen today. I'm going to be baking a coffee cake for the Baycroft Bake Off. And here are some of the ingredients I'm going to be using. So we've got some butter and some coffee. It's going to be a delicious coffee cappuccino cake, which is my favourite type. We have some chocolate coffee beans, some butterscotch essence, baking powder, self-raising flour, sugar, a few pecan nuts to decorate, and most important, the eggs here. So in a few minutes I'll be starting to mix up and I'll show you what comes out at the end when I'm finished.
Hello Baycroft, Mr. West here, and I'm going to just run through what I'm going to be making for the Baycroft Bake Off. I'm going to make a sunflower sponge cake with a layer of lemon butter frosting on the middle and iced petals and chocolate button seeds. Hopefully it will all work out okay. Bye for now.
Hi, it's Mrs. Dunk here. I'm going to be making jammy cupcakes for the VE Day Bake Off.
Mm-hmm. again. Don't know when, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know, tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We meet again, don't know when.
What do you think? Not bad go. Now for the twist. You have to try it. Now the recipe says, leave to cool for 5 minutes. I've got this little one here. She's hot. Oh, look at the insides. Would you believe it? Oh, now, let's just open this. Gotta try it. Hello again. I finished my baking and this is the end result.
Hi everybody, this is Miss Sarah's. This is my entry to the Baycroft Bake Off Challenge and it's just chocolate and more chocolate and some more chocolate. Bye!
Good morning, Baycroft. It's that time of the week again where we are back to do the house points total. It's been a really busy week. It's lovely for me to be back again to see you this morning and to give you that update. Just wanted to once more say a massive thank you for all of you for taking part and sending all of that work through. Yet again, we've been so impressed with the quality and the quantity of work that you are sending through to us. So well done and keep that going. You will see on the screen, it is that virtual token collector. Yellow house have gone into the lead with a massive 110 points. They've edged in front of Blue House, who have been in the lead for the last 2 weeks, and they've gone into the lead by 1 point. So well done. But as you can see, it's still all to play for. This can change on a weekly basis. We've seen an increase of students in Yellow House that have been sending their work through, and that has made the difference and has put Yellow House into the lead. So you can see that the work that you are doing for your house teams is so crucial in terms of collecting those points and supporting your houses. So I just wanted to recognise, like I did last week, some students that have made a significant contribution again, and we'll start with Red House. And that's Chantal. Chantal has been consistent every week in terms of the amount of points she's collected. So well done to Chantal in 10 JMO. This week you collected another 16 points for your house. In Greenhouse we have Caden in 7 LDO. And Caden managed to collect 7 points for the Greenhouse this week. So well done and thank you to Caden. And then in Yellow House we have Rosie May in 7 ST. So well done to Rosie, who managed on her own to collect 14 points for Yellow House and definitely made a significant contribution, which put Yellow House into the lead this week. So well done, Rosie, for your support and your work that you sent through to us. And finally, we have Luke from 8LMC, who also collected 14 points this week. So well done and thank you to Luke. As you can see, it's still all to play for. It's so important that you get involved and you continue to support your house and your teams. So in order to do that, make sure that you continue watching Baycroft TV. Make sure that you keep sending all of that work through to us. It's an absolute pleasure to be able to look at all of it coming through. And make sure, most importantly, that you continue to keep yourself safe and well, and that you look after all of your parents, your siblings, and make sure you enjoy the weekend, this weekend. That's it from me this week, and I look forward to being back with you next Friday. Take care, have a good weekend. Bye.
Today's sign is remember. Remember.
Hello again, Baycroft. It's Mr. West here. I really hope you've enjoyed today's special VE Day episode of our YouTube broadcast. And what do you think of some of the amazing baking skills staff at Baycroft have? Remember, please email us and tell us who you think should win the Great Baycroft Bake Off. Now that's a mouthful, isn't it? The Great Baycroft Bake Off. See, finally got it right at the end there. Anyway, couple of announcements to make before I sign off. The first one is we've decided that this week two students will be receiving gift vouchers. So firstly, a huge well done to Chantal from 10 JMO, and secondly, a huge well done to Cameron from 10 MHY. We'll be contacting you shortly and your gift vouchers will be sent to you. And the last important announcement I have to make is the next episode of our YouTube channel will be going out next Tuesday, because all the staff need to sort of have a bit of a rest over the bank holiday weekend and get ready to make some more fantastic episodes for you to enjoy. Bye for now. With a honey like you, send me, baby, send me.